figure out how the giants work. And they said when the 12 spies went to spy on the promised land, they come back and they said, we can't go in the promised land because there are giants over there. So who were those giants? Were the giants known for what? Back in Genesis we talked about the when the sons of God and the daughters of men evidently cohabitated and they begat giants. And they were like a hybrid between like half man and half demon, and they were giants. And so do you think those giants that they saw from the 12 spies and all that, were they Nephilim or were they something else? Anybody know? Anybody have an opinion? Nobody really knows because none of us were there. That's right, Bigfoot, Lee County, Virginia. Big knowledge that he's everywhere. Bigfoot, Lee County. I seen Bigfoot sign right behind my house. Anybody seen a Bigfoot?
Oh yeah, arch tree.
Yeah, tree sign. Yeah. He watches too much TV. He's like me. Yeah. He knows anybody else here ever heard of the Ames team. Yeah.
These guys are not humble. Go ahead.
Ames, what does Ames team stand for?
Appalachian.
Investigators of mysterious sightings. Yeah. And so if you've seen the Bigfoot, you need to call the Ames team. They'll come check it out. It's called, what is the name of the trip? Mountain Monster. So yeah, that's probably what it was. Even back in the Book of Numbers, they had Bigfoot roaming around everywhere. And that's probably I reckon so. It could be a descendant of Bigfoot. That's right.
I think the Giants were in New York.
I still can't hear you.
The Giants were in New York.
Oh. But maybe that's what it was. Maybe they were mistaken and they were seeing basketball or football game over there in the promised land. Ever what it was, we don't know. I suspect that all those giants from Book of Genesis probably got drowned in the flood. Because the Bible says everything that had the breath of life in it died pretty much. So I think they were probably just exaggerating a little bit. They were scared and they said, we can't go over there because there's giants over there. We look like grasshoppers compared to it. Excuse me. Long story short, everybody that was there that didn't go in the promised land, they died in the wilderness because they were too stubborn and hard-headed to enter into the promised land. And there was two of the spies that did get into the promised land. Anybody know who they were?
Joshua
and Caleb. And then all the children got to enter the promised land after what?
After all the first generation had died.
Yep. God made them do laps around that mountain until everybody died that was disobedient. And so it was a sad thing. A land flowing with milk and honey. A land that God had made just for them, but they would not enter into it because of their fear and because of the lack of faith. And what I said before, I just wonder how many of us have a promised land that God has prepared for us. A land where we could go and be blessed and just receive all of God's blessings, but we have giants holding us back, scaring us, and keeping us from entering into what God has for us. So many...
That's what a giant is, when your fear is bigger than your faith.
Yep, and a giant could be anything. It could be, a giant could be your bank account. A giant could be health issue, a giant could be for a teenager, could be a bully. You know, there's all kinds of giants out there. The thing is, God is bigger than any of our giants. We just trust in Him through Jesus Christ. We can overcome anything. Because victory is ours. We have victory in who? Ourselves? What does the song say? Victory in Jesus. So I encourage everybody to enter into your promise. But see, we're going to talk about something different tonight. did not enter into the promised land, and as a result of that, they had a whole lot of problems. Anytime that God's got something that he wants you to do, or a task he wants you to take on, or a calling he wants you to fulfill, and you don't do it, then guess what? You're going to have problems. You're going to have problems. Number one, you ain't never going to be fulfilled in your life. You're going to always feel like something's missing. And when people feel like something's missing in their life, what do? They try to fill it. And usually, what do they try to fill it with? Anything except what is missing. Because in reality, if your life, if you don't feel fulfilled in your life, then the answer does not lie in drugs, alcohol, money, women, men, your job, or whatnot. The answer lies in Jesus. Jesus is the only one who can give you fulfillment in your life. The only way to get that fulfillment is to walk in the calling that Jesus Christ has for you. And what we can't understand, what we don't want to understand is that God has a specific calling for each and every one of us. No matter who you are, if you are a born again child of God, then God has a calling upon your life. He has a purpose for you. He has something that he wants you to do. And a lot of times it's more than one thing that he wants you to do. But the number one thing is to walk in obedience. And if you don't walk in obedience, you're not going to have fulfillment, and you're going to be in rebellion against God. You're going to be rebelling against him. And one of the main problems that the people in the wilderness had, and that's what we're in this section, we're talking about the life of Moses, and in this section we're talking about the wilderness wanderings. And so the reason that the people were wandering in the wilderness is because they were rebelling against God. They wouldn't go into the promised land, so they're stuck out in the wilderness. It's kind of like a lot of people think that ghosts, there's such thing as ghosts. And they think that a ghost comes from, like, I guess, best I can understand it, that they feel like when a person dies and they don't go into the light, then they're stuck between here and the afterlife. And that's kind of what the Israelites were. They were stuck in between. They didn't go into the promised land. They couldn't go back to Egypt. They wanted to, and that's what this rebellion, that was Korah's deal. Korah got up a group of people, and he said, look, I think we need to go back to Egypt or do something because I ain't satisfied with what Moses is doing. Let's get back to Egypt. And so not only was he rebelling against God, but he was rebelling against Moses. And it's like these people that believe in ghosts. Now, I believe in ghosts. Yeah, it's one ghost. The Holy Ghost. It ain't no such thing as ghosts. Okay, I hate to bust your bubble. And Christy's sister goes on these ghost hunts. And, you know, she's a Christian. She goes on a ghost hunt. And goes to all these haunted places. And I just can't understand. I said to her, I said, you know, I don't have to hunt after stuff like that because it usually finds me out. Because while I don't think there's only one ghost, that's the Holy Ghost. But what people perceive to be ghosts, I think, are demons. Yeah. And so if you're going ghost hunting, really, what are you doing? You're going demon hunting. I don't have to hunt them. They hunt me. Okay? They're after me all the time. And I've encountered some mighty terrible demons. And we think that demons are not real. I'm going to tell you, demons are real. And this world is full of them. And they're spiritual beings. And as I've said many times before, there's a spiritual war going on all around us right now. The fallen angels that we're talking about are in a battle with the good angels right now as we speak. And so we think that there's ghosts and disembodied spirits. And you just can't believe in a ghost and believe the Bible at the same time. Because it won't work. One of them's got to be either such thing as ghosts. And when I say ghost, I'm talking about what most people would consider a ghost would be somebody that died, but they didn't cross over. Didn't, you know, they said, don't go to the light. Stay away from the light. It's something about the light. If you go into the light, then you go to the other side. People think that you have the ability, and where they get this from, I'm going to stay away from the light. And so you just wander around. You're a disembodied spirit. You're wandering the earth. There's no such thing. How do we know that? How do we know that this is not possible? Come back and tell me that they got stuck in between. But the Bible says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. When you die, a lot of people would like to think, especially unsaved people, they like to think that they could stay away from the light. Because if you're not saved and you go into the light, where are you really going? Yeah, you're going to judgment. You're going to go stand before God. And if you're not saved, He's sending you south for the winter. This will be a long winter. Yeah, so I think that's where this idea of ghosts comes from. They want to believe that, hey, I'm not saved, so I'll just stay away from the light and I'll be a ghost and I'll wander the earth. I'll be like Patrick Swayze and get to dance with people and stuff. And, you know, it's just not true. When you die, you're going to see Jesus. Now, a lot of people talk about what it's like to die. And nobody knows because nobody's come back and told except for one, and that was Jesus. But I'm not so much concerned with what happens like the second that I die as to what happens like 30 seconds after I die. Because 30 seconds after you die, where do you think you're going to be at? You're going to be standing face to face with Jesus. And He's going to be a judge. He's going to be sentencing you. He's either going to say, well done, my good and faithful son, come enter ye into the rest that I have prepared for you from before the foundation of the earth. Or He's going to say that other thing that nobody wants to hear. And what is that? Yep, depart from me, you working for me iniquity. I never knew you. And what are they going to say? But wait, we cast out demons in your name and we come to church and we was on committees and we taught Sunday school and what is he going to say? I never knew. How could that be? How could it be that somebody, and it's probably going to be preachers, I'll preach the gospel for you. I never knew you. How is it that you can possibly go to church all your life every Sunday? You could tithe and teach Sunday school and preach and still go to hell. How is that? Am I wrong? Maybe I'm wrong.
It's knowledge within your head and not heart.
I've heard it said before that a lot of people miss heaven by this far. It's this far right here between your head and your heart. That's how much you miss it by. It ain't about your church attendance. It ain't about how much you tithe. It ain't about how many Sunday school classes you teach or how much you serve. And don't get